This is the new Model 3 Performance that just came to our possession, and a lot of you have been asking us to do a comparison between this model and the 2019 model, and this is what we are here to do. Now, this is not going to be a range test video, rather this is going to be only an acceleration video. I strongly believe that people who buy this car mainly buy it because of its performance. So if you want to watch like a range test video, maybe Bjorn is going to be a better person to see. But in this video, I'm going to tell you a little bit more about the difference between these two beautiful cars. And we're going to be using a gadget so we can track how fast it's going to accelerate 0 to 100 and also how fast it's going to do a quarter mile. So if you wonder what we're using for this type of test, this is it. This is the Racebox Pro. I'm going to leave a link to their website in the description of this video. They're amazing guys doing amazing things, so you definitely should go and check them out. But let me tell you a little bit more about the specs of these two beautiful cars. Now, even though this doesn't look like a Tesla anymore, this is still the 2019 Model 3 Performance. We have upgraded with a full body kit. If you haven't seen our entire video of the transition of this car, make sure to click on the top right banner. Now, what's new on this car is almost everything. We put a front bumper and lip. We also changed the hood. Now it's the same stock Michelin tires, and we also added this carbon fiber wing as well as the diffuser at the back. And we're gonna see how this is gonna affect the performance of this vehicle. This car is straight from the factory. This is how it looks when you get it. These are the standard 20-inch Pirelli tires rather than the Michelin ones that the Tesla was using. It's interesting because our standard range Model 3 Highland came with the Michelin tires, but I guess they changed it for the performance model. Now, on the outside, how you can realize that this is a performance car? By obviously Tesla is always changing the little spoiler at the back. Now it's carbon fiber, and also there's a little change on the dash, but everything else is pretty much the same. Now, tell me down in the comments, what do you think about these wheels? They're pretty interesting. I'm still debating if I like them or not, but let me know what you think. Now, a little bit more technical things about both cars. Now, the 2019 model can produce up to 510 horsepower, which is insane for this caliber of vehicle. But for the new one, Tesla has decided to reduce the amount of horsepower it produced down to 460, I believe. Now, I'm not exactly sure why this is. I've heard that the battery that they are installing in these cars for the European and Chinese market are different than the one for the US market. So that's why they had to reduce the horsepower of the car. But you can also let me down in the comment. And if you want to look more into details video about technical specs, Kyle from Auto Spec is definitely the guy to look for. He's so well educated on these things, so I definitely recommend you watching his review. In terms of weight, both cars are pretty much identical. The differences are very tiny, but the shape of this vehicle makes it technically a little bit more drag coefficient than this one. We're gonna be accelerating first with the Model 3 2019 to see what time it's gonna give us, and then we're gonna jump into the new one and see what the results is gonna be. Now we're in the 2019 model. As you can see, the Racebox Pro is connected. We're also gonna be screen recording the performance of the motor and the discharge of it via our application, which I'm gonna put on the screen in a second. But Dimitar,
yeah.
Let's hit on the accelerator.
Okay.
Ready?
Yes.
Let's do it.
Two, one.
Now, that was crazy. Even though this car is 5 years old, it's still very snappy, and this is one of the major things we love Tesla. The response is insane. The feeling never gets old. And here are the results on the Racebox Pro. So 0 to 100 kilometers per hour we did in 3.66 seconds. Now, again, we are two people inside the car and the battery is on about 65%. And a quarter mile we did in 12.5 seconds. If you've never been in a Tesla Model 3 Performance, those are great results, especially for a car that's 5 years old. And let's check our app. So the maximum discharge both motors combined did is 382 kilowatts, which I'm not even sure if that's the number we're going to be able to reach on the Model 3 performance. However, one thing I didn't mention is something that a lot of you are going to point out. Now, both cars have two motors, one in the front and one in the rear. Tesla have been using the same motors for the Model 3 performance for a long time, but with the new car, they changed the rear motor. They actually took the one from the Model S Plaid, which is right over there, and they put it on this car here. So technically, this model should be performing much better than this car, but that's enough talking. Let's check out what it can do. Now, let me show you briefly what's the difference in terms of how this car looks from the inside. Now, we have a video showing you how a Model 3 Highland standard range looks like, but this is the performance model. It's still the same steering wheel, which is amazing, by the way. They've changed the dash to this carbon fiber one, which I really like, but the main visual difference is the new seats, which you might already seen. Extremely comfortable, especially when you wanna go on a drag strip or a track. And let's check what's the differences when it comes to driving. Now, you do not have a sport mode anymore compared to the old model. Now it's insane. And you also have option to control your suspensions. Now you can drive it in a standard mode, which I believe is going to be similar to the one on the standard range models. And you have a sport mode, which makes them a little bit stiffer, what I've heard, but I haven't actually driven this car yet. So I'm going to give my impression in a few minutes. Now Dimitar is going to reset the two. By the way, look how good the new software version of this car looks like. We still don't have it on our old model, but we're gonna get it very soon. But on this one, looks very impressive. All right, 0 to 100 and quarter mile test. Ready?
I'm ready.
Let's hit it.
3, 2, 1.
Oh, wow. That was faster. Jeez. 3.4, I think. Wow.
Yeah.
That's impressive. Now from here, I already can see that it made the quarter mile in 11.6 seconds. And by the way, those nerds that are gonna say what's the percentage of your battery is, it's 59, so both cars are pretty similar. And by the way, colleagues of ours were doing tests on this model and our model for an hour already, so the batteries are pretty warmed up. There is nowhere else to go. So I believe this is the optimal test that it can be done. By the way, the suspension right now, are we on sport mode or standard mode? Okay, the stiff definitely feels sporty, but let's change to a standard. Yeah, they're a little bit more bouncy, a little bit more soft, which is I guess good for everyday driving. But the sport one, I feel like I like it. But the biggest thing I actually like about this car, maybe it's hard for you to hear through the mic, but it's so much more quieter than the 2019 model, guys. It's insane, especially when you're trying to accelerate to these fast speeds. You can definitely tell the difference. All right, let's check out the results. So the Model 3 Performance 2024 did 0 to 100 in 3.41 seconds. And quarter mile in 11.6 seconds. Now I'm gonna put them on the screen side by side just so you can refresh your memory how it was with the 2019 model. But let's see also what's the discharge that this car produced. Now, at the same speed of about 675 kilometers per hour, it produced 380 kilowatts discharge. Now, this car is faster, as you can see on the results, but it produces less discharge. What does this mean? So maybe because the motor at the back is the one from the plate, maybe it just doesn't peak that high as the old car, which might reflect in better range performance also. What do you think? All right, you saw the results between these two cars. To be honest, they're both insane, super fast, super responsive. I'm not even sure if I had to change this car, I would go for this one. Yes, it's fast, it's amazing, it's very comfortable. It has these benefits that it needs to give us a new car, and great job Tesla on creating this amazing vehicle. But I still love this car, especially right now after we mod it like this. but go down in the comments and let me know your thoughts. If you are owner of an older Model 3, would you change for the new one and why? Thank you so much for watching this video, and I hope this result gave you clearance of how this beautiful car performs. See you soon.